And welcome back. Well, that didn't go well. Basically, the bubble popped while I was trying to do that intro. So, well, that sucked. I'm just gonna keep going. I'm not gonna restart the video, because that would mean I actually have to make my way back there off screen, which only takes about a minute anyway. And besides, there's not really enough to fill out an entire episode if I just had to show two other things. So this all works out. But yeah, there's only actually one more star other than this that we can actually get. Last time we actually got most of them in the Melty Molten Galaxy. I think that's the name of this one. Yeah. So yeah, all that's left is one Hungry Luma, which we can nowhere near afford at the moment. So again, that's part of the reason, besides I have 20 lives, why dying really isn't a problem, because when you die, it resets all the star bits, but you also get to keep all the ones you already collected. So it's really not an issue dying, and in a way it's actually good. If you get enough star bits, even you get more lives, so it all works out in the end anyway. This will probably be a really short video, by the way, because I want to save the final Bowser level for a different video, like a separate video. I wouldn't want to just tack it on and then split it up. I want to make the finale its own video. Which, by the way, next time is the finale. So yeah, this will probably be a little bit short. I apologize for that, but yeah, what was I saying? Yeah, this will be a little bit, well, actually, what I probably should say is that the next part will probably more than make up for it lengthwise, because we have quite a lot of endgame to get through. Not spoilers. Again, in terms of basic lore and development and story even, this game is pretty grand compared to most Mario games. Even though Sunshine had voice acting, this game still manages to have better presentation of story somehow. Again, this is coming from someone who prefers Sunshine, even though I do think this is the better game. Again, I just find Sunshine more nostalgic. And yes, I completely attribute it to nostalgia, because that game has some really weird design choices. And it's kind of a mess once you get to the end game, even more than this game. So yeah, I think 64 is actually a better made game than Sunshine, even, on the whole. Now, I don't know if there's actually a checkpoint here. I think you have to restart the entire mission, if I'm right. So that sucks. If you die, just try not to die. But again, you can get a lot of star bits in this particular world. This also reminds me of that one place in Wind Waker. What's the name of it? It's not Icewing Isle. It's the counterpart to Icewing Isle, but I don't know the name of it. This part's scary, by the way, because you basically are waiting for that to sink down so you can wall jump up, but you're also like cutting it really close. I don't know if that's on a timer or not, or if it's kind of fixed. I almost think it's fixed just because of how much can go wrong if you're just off cycle by a few seconds. Just try and do the speedrun tactics again. Save time. And there we go. And I hope I don't get sniped by the enemy last minute, because that would be bad. That was way too close, actually. So now I get to show something a little bit on the tricky, tricksy side. Because, as you can probably guess, we are a little bit short. We're 700 star bits short. No, not 700. 500 star bits short. That's really not much, though. So what we want to do... I did this trick off-screen to get to the Snow Cap Galaxy, I think was the name of it. But I will show it in all of its glory this time. So what you want to do is, as I said last time, go to the Sling Pod Galaxy. But I didn't actually talk about the trick, I just said, go to the Sling Pod Galaxy. So now, I shall show the thing. Again, this would be a short video if I just immediately cut to the Hungry Luma, so... might as well. Sling Pod's outside. That's right. Yeah, we're at the end. There's only one more star that we can actually get before Bowser. Basically, at the Sling Pod Galaxy, there are so many star bits, and it gets to the point where you can get a ton of extra lives this way. The amount of extra lives you get here is ridiculous, to the point where you can actually never game over if you do it right. See, we're like right off the bat, we get a ton of star bits. This isn't even the trick part yet, by the way. It's not even that. But yeah, right off the bat, you actually get an extra life. It's nice of the game to do that. Is this off-cycle? It feels like it's off-cycle. I missed, but that's not a big deal. This illustrates my point. No matter where you start, if it's at the beginning or the end, but preferably at the end of the level, it responds all the star bits. Which is good. Which is what we want. So yeah, dying at the beginning, that actually happened off-screen too. Probably after this cannonball. It's after this next part. So we got these guys. I'm using the coin to line up, actually. It's actually really hard to look at Mario and the cans at the same time. After this. Basically, at this point, you get all of these, which is kind of ridiculous, if you actually stop and collect every one. Just to show it's a lot safer, too. But here is where the trick lies. This is your checkpoint. If you launch yourself over here, this creates a string of star bits that goes all the way over there. That's a lot. You notice our count went up quite a bit. So what you want to actually do is die. And then basically that coin will respawn, and then you can actually if I'm understanding the trick correctly. Can I do this? This is faster. But yeah, basically you get so many star bits here. Chances are one, you're gonna get an extra life, two, I missed the sling pod. But you can just kind of keep respawning them to the point where you can easily rack up enough to get hundreds in no time flat. So I'm gonna be doing this for a little bit, and I'll meet you back at the Hungry Luma. Believe it or not, that only took about 5 minutes actually to get that many star bits. So about 100 star bits per minute is actually a pretty good time ratio. It actually took longer to set up some video stuff than actually getting enough star bits, because I thought, oh, I have time to do this, and then in actuality, not really. So we are taking on the Boo's Boneyard Galaxy, which is the last star we can actually get at this point in the game. Other than Bowser, of course, last regular star. It's race with Boo. So we need the Boo Mushroom for this. We can pass through the glass. So you're after two. You'll have to race me for it. Here we go. So we have a Boo. Is it just me, or is this really pixely? Like, is it just me, or is it like really pixelating right now? but yeah, like it looks really grainy for some reason. I'm not sure if it's sure what's going on with that. So you take a little bit of a shortcut there, which is a good idea to do. These are springs; they stop you. You can hold Z, I think, to fall a little bit faster, but not super fast at that. This is just designed to slow you down, basically. So this is a fan, so definitely want to activate that, if possible. I guess you could say it's Mario's biggest fan. I think it's all the wavy stuff, but for some reason, yeah, this area just looks really pixely for me, to me. We barely won that, but okay. 51-48? Well, promise is a promise, so take this. I wonder what the Boo would think of Mario not being Mario for this. Also, if you're wondering, this is actually the first time I've played this game on an HD display. That's why I think I noticed all the pixelation there. Because typically I've always played this on a Wii. This is the first time I've actually played this on a Wii U. So it's like, wow, that looks really grainy for some reason. Now, it only took 2 minutes. And with that, we have actually collected every regular power star that we can get at this point. 104. 152 star bits. I'm gonna toss a star bit just so I can have the number of star bits that matches the number of original Pokemon. And let's talk to Luma and see the list. So this is our list of stars we've gotten so far. You can even send it to your home menu if you so desire. It also keeps track of best race times, including the one we just did. The ones with crowns are the ones we've completed, meaning there are no bonus stars. The ones without crowns are the ones with purple coins. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14... Wait, 14? I thought they're... Wait, did I miscount? There should be 15. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. There, 15. These are the ones with purple coins. Good Egg, Honey Hive. Not sure about Space Junk. Balrog, Beach Bowl. Gussy Garden is not one, so yeah. Good Egg, Honey Hive. Balrog. Freeze Flame. No, not Gold Leaf. Sea Slide, definitely. Deep Dark and Melty Molten are not timed. I think all the other ones are timed. I might be wrong on that. Sadly, like Space Junk, I'm pretty sure is timed. Maybe not. I'll have to. We'll find out when we get there. Ghostly is definitely timed and it's a complete pain in the butt. It's one of the tougher ones. Gussy Garden is timed, it's in the little cube hedge maze where we found the rabbit. Freeze Flame is not timed, but it's also the most time consuming, if you ask me. Dusty Dune is timed, it's in like the part where we have to like raise that one platform to get the second star, I think. Toy Time is timed on the 8-bit Mario, I think. Or I might be thinking Galaxy 2, but it's also really, really awful. It's a really difficult one. It's called Luigi's Purple Coins, and it's rather infamous. Deep Dark, I don't think it's timed. Dreadnought isn't timed, but again, you're on a moving platform, so you are essentially timed. And Melty Molten, I don't think it's timed. So, unfortunately, we have a work cut out for us here. This is gonna... We're gonna average like a star per video, probably, most likely, from a lot of these. So yeah, our progress is gonna slow down considerably. But for now, all we have left. Did I save? Because I meant to save. All we have left is to head to the center of the universe in order to confront Bowser. Which we will be doing next time. So, thank you for watching, and I hope you join me next time for more Super Mario Galaxy.